Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video I am going to discuss about the sulfur halides and their synthetic applications. This video is the continuation of previous videos. In the previous videos we have discussed about the generation of sulfur halides and classification of sulfur halides and their reactivity. In the case of reactivity of the sulfur halides, we have discussed about important reaction, that is Johnson-Corey-Chekhovsky reaction, where we can synthesize epoxides, azridines and cyclopropyl derivatives from sulfur halides. And also we have discussed the reactions of sulfur halides, where the reaction of the sulfur halide with the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds, which generates cyclopropane derivatives or oxo spiro derivatives or epoxides. And we have discussed the synthesis of spirenes from the sulfur halides and the generation of alkenes from the sulfur halides. And these sulfur halides can also undergo rearrangement. For example, different kind of sulfur halides undergo rearrangement, such as alkyl sulfur halides, allyl sulfur halides, benzyl, azo and oxo sulfur halides. So these sulfur halides can undergo either 1-2 kind of 1-2 sigma tropic rearrangement or 3-2 sigma tropic rearrangement. So this video is a continuation of previous lecture, that is the rearrangement of sulfur halides. So let us start with another example of azo sulfur halide, where it undergo rearrangement. Coming to the azo sulfur halide, for example, let us take an azo sulfur halide . This sulfur halide can undergo 3-2 sigma tropic rearrangement. So let us start the discussion of the preparation of this azo sulfur halide. So how to prepare this azo sulfur halide? Once you get this sulfur halide, let us discuss about the rearrangement involved in this. So the preparation starts with the treatment of chloroamine derivative with the sulfide. So sulfur with its lone pair, it attack onto the electrophilic nitrogen, which gives you a sulfonium salt. This sulfonium salt, upon treatment with the base, which abstract the proton which is adjacent to the sulfonium ion and gives you the vicinal ionic intermediate, which is called azo sulfur halide. So this azo sulfur halide, now it can undergo 3-2 sigma tropic rearrangement. See, this is 1 and this is 2 and 1, 2, 3. So now this azo sulfur halide is undergoing 3-2 sigma tropic rearrangement. Which gives you sulfide. Now this imine will undergo tautomerism and gives you aniline derivative. Once it undergoes 3-2 sigma tropic rearrangement, it is giving an aniline derivative. So this aniline can act as intramolecular nucleophile and attack onto this carbonyl carbon and gives you a 5-membered ring. Now, the loss of water molecule gives you a benzo-fused heterocycle. This one undergo 1-3 tautomerism and gives you an indole derivative. Now, this thiol containing indole derivative, once you treat with raninickel hydrogenation, the desulfurization takes place. Raninickel, it is a nickel which gives you an indole derivative by desulfurization process, indole derivative. So this is the synthetic application of azo sulfur iodide. So first we have generated the azo sulfur iodide by treating this chloro aniline derivative with the sulfide, which gives you sulfonium salt. This sulfonium salt, once you treat with the base, it generates vicinal ionic intermediate called sulfur iodide, which contains azo group in this, so it is called as azo sulfur iodide. This azo sulfur iodide, as we discussed earlier, it undergoes 3-2 sigma tropic rearrangement, which gives you an aniline derivative. So this aniline derivative again undergo intramolecular nucleophilic addition by, and also it is undergoing ring cyclization, and it gives you a cyclic product, benzo-fused cyclic product. So the loss of water followed by 1,3 tautomerism gives you a thiol indole derivative, thiol substituted indole derivative. So followed by the treatment of this indole derivative, which contains a thio functional group, once you treat with this raninickel, the desulfurization takes place and gives you an indole derivative. So this is all about the synthetic application with azo sulfur iodide. Come to the other application where the preparation of sulfur iodide generally comes from sulfides. So let us take a sulfide. Now let us take a cyclic sulfide. This sulfide treat with allyl chloride. So what happens, this sulfur which is having lone pair acts as nucleophile and attack onto this electrophilic carbon. And gives you the sulfonium salt. Once you get this sulfonium salt, treatment with the base which abstract the proton from here. The which gives you a sulfur halide. Sulfur halide. Now this sulfur halide can undergo two different type of reactions. Either it can undergo rearrangement, or the carbanion which is present in this halide can act as nucleophile. Once you treat this nucleophile with an alpha beta unsaturated ester, this gives you sulfonium salt. Sulfonium salt. So that means the formed halides which are having a carbanion, so which can act as a nucleophile, can undergo reaction with the alpha beta unsaturated esters, which gives you an alkyl derivative. Or this sulfur halide can also undergo rearrangement. Here this is 1, 2, 3, and this is 1 and 2. So it can undergo 3-2 sigmatropic rearrangement, which opens this ring. So sulfonium will convert to sulfide. Again, this sulfide treat with the alkene derivatives in presence of acid, which gives you the sulfonium salt. Now, treatment of this sulfonium with the base, which generates a sulfur halide. Here this counter anion comes from this acid. If you take HCl, you will get here Cl minus. Okay, now, so this base treatment of this sulfonium salt will generate a sulfur halide. This sulfur halide can undergo 3-2 sigmatropic rearrangement. See 1, 2, and 3. Here this is 1 and 2. So, sulfonium after rearrangement is
converting to sulfide. So like this you will get a macrocyclic sulfur compounds from this sulfur halides. So this is also one kind of synthetic application with this sulfur halide. So we have started the reaction with the sulfide by treating with allyl chloride, followed by you are getting a sulfonium salt. This sulfonium salt upon treatment with the base, for example, if you take here tertiary butoxide which abstract the proton, tertiary butoxide, so which abstract the proton and generates sulfur halides. So this sulfur halide, it can undergo two different type of reactions. One is this can alkylated by treating with the alpha beta unsaturated esters or anything alkyl halides, you will get an alkylated product. This sulfur halide can undergo 3-2 sigmatropic rearrangement, gives you a sulfide, rearranged sulfide, followed by again formation of sulfonium ion, followed by the treatment of base which produce a sulfur halide. So these are all rearranged sulfides, okay, these sulfur halides. So rearranged sulfur halides again undergo 3-2 kind of rearrangement. So likewise you can treat again this sulfur, you can continue with the next further reactions and get a macrocyclic rings. So this is one kind of synthetic application with the sulfur halides. Coming to the other application, so that is called Pommerer rearrangement. So Pommerer rearrangement, it is a rearrangement of sulfur halides. See this reaction where the conversion of alkyl sulfoxides or rearrangement of alkyl sulfoxides to an alpha azyloxy thioether, which is also called as monothioacetal ester in presence of acetic anhydride. So this reaction is called Pommerer reaction or Pommerer rearrangement. So in this Pommerer rearrangement, generally the rearrangement of alkyl sulfoxides to an alpha azyloxy thioethers when they treat with the acetic anhydrides. So generally you are synthesizing alpha azyloxy thioethers from alkyl sulfoxides. For example, let us take dimethyl sulfoxide. When you treat with the acetic anhydride, so this dimethyl sulfoxide, when you treat with acetic anhydride, this can undergo rearrangement and gives you alpha azyloxy thioether, which is also called as methyl thio methyl acetate or alpha azyloxy thioethers. So this is the Pommerer rearrangement, where the rearrangement of dialkyl sulfoxides or alkyl sulfoxides to alpha azyloxy thioethers in presence of acetic anhydride. Let us discuss about the mechanism involved in this Pommerer rearrangement. So the mechanism generally starts with the azylation of dimethyl sulfoxide. So dimethyl sulfoxide, when you treat with the acetic anhydride, the lone pair of electrons in this dimethyl sulfoxide act as a nucleophile, attack onto this electrophilic carbon, where the loss of acetate which gives you the sulfoxonium or oxonium intermediate. So this can undergo resonance
and gives you a sulfonium salt. So this sulfonium salt is stabilized by this counter anion, that is acetate. Now this acetate, which is a conjugate base obtained from weak acid, so that it can abstract this proton from this alpha carbon, which is to sulfonium which gives you halide. Okay, this halide again it undergo elimination. So the loss of or elimination of this acetate gives you a thiol, cationic thiol intermediate. Cationic thiol. So this cationic thiol intermediate is the important one here. So here this CH2 is an electrophilic carbon. Okay, now the released acetate, the released acetate acts as a nucleophile and attack onto this electrophilic carbon and gives the rearranged product, that is methyl acetate. So the mechanism starts with the acylation of this dimethyl sulfoxide, which gives you oxonium. So it has a resonance structure, that means where the sulfur gets positive charge, that means it is sulfonium salt. So now this sulfonium salt, the reaction with the acetate produce halide. So indirectly there is a rearrangement takes place here. Once this halide generation occurs, there is a loss of acetate ion takes place and gives you cationic thiol intermediate. And then the nucleophilic addition of this acetate onto this electrophilic carbon in this cationic thiol, which produce the rearranged product methyl thiol, methyl acetate. If you observe carefully, alpha carbon to this sulfur generally undergo acylation here. See this CH2, see this CH3, alpha carbon to this sulfur generally undergo acylation and gives you a rearranged product. So this is what about Pommerer rearrangement. Come to the other application, that is with the sulfur halides. The reaction is called Julia reaction. So this reaction is also called as Julia olefination or Julia Lithok olefination. The name itself indicates that it is a olefination reaction, that means which mainly produce alkenes. But this Julia reaction is multi-step reaction, so several kind of reactions generally occurs, and then this reaction produces mainly e-alkenes. So it produces trans alkenes from the substrates. Let us start the reaction by taking an example. In this Julia reaction, the main substrate is sulfones. Okay, it's called sulfones. So this sulfones, treatment of this sulfone with the base followed by carbonyl compound, that means aldehyde or ketone, followed by treatment with acetic anhydride, and finally the reductive elimination with sodium amalgam, which generally produce E alkenes. E alkenes mainly. So the starting substrates are sulfones. So starting substrates are sulfones. So indirectly, the conversion of these sulfones to alkenes. Alkenes in presence of base, carbonyl compounds, acetic anhydride and sodium amalgam. So that is called actually Julia reaction or Julia olefination reaction. What kind of mechanism involved in this multi-step reaction? So let us discuss about this. So the mechanism starts with the treatment of this sulfone with the base. For example, I am taking an organolithium which abstracts the proton and generates a carbanion. This phenyl sulfonyl carbanion, which acts as a nucleophile and undergo nucleophilic addition reaction with the aldehydes, which produce an intermediate alcohol. This alcohol undergo acylation process or esterification in situ and produces acetate. This acetate further undergo reductive elimination with sodium amalgam, which produces the required alkene, especially it is E alkene. So the main application with this Julia olefination is the generation of E alkenes. So the mechanism here, the mechanism starts with the abstraction of proton in sulfones by base, which produces phenyl sulfonyl carbanion, which acts as a nucleophile, and it undergo nucleophilic addition reaction with the carbonyl compounds and produces an alcohol intermediate. This alcohol and intermediate undergo esterification in situ, followed by the reductive elimination of this derivative gives you the product, that is E alkenes. So this reductive elimination generally occurs generally in radical mechanism. You see, once you treat this ester with the sodium amalgam, so this metal produces a free radical. So this free radical, as we know, it is a planar structure, so it can rotate around the C-C single bond. So it can rotate around the C-C single bond, followed by the electron obtained from other metal, which produces carbanion. So this carbanion further undergo loss of acetate and produce our required E alkene. So this is what generally the mechanism occurs in the reductive elimination process. So generally it is undergoing radical fashion and it generates a carbanion and the loss of acetate, which produces E alkenes. So this is all about Julia reaction. So Julia reaction or Julia olefination reaction is a multi-steps reaction which is mainly useful for the preparation of E alkenes from sulfones. So the reaction starts with the treatment of sulfones with the base, which generally produce a carbanion. This carbanion undergo nucleophilic addition reaction with the nucleophilic addition reaction with the carbonyl compounds, that means aldehydes, which produce alcohol intermediate. This alcohol intermediate undergo in situ esterification process and produce ester. So this ester undergo reductive elimination with the sodium amalgam, which mainly produces e-alkene. So this is a very important reaction, which is mainly useful for the synthesis of e-alkenes. So this is all about the synthetic applications of sulfur halides. So the synthetic applications of this sulfur halides are Johnson-Cory-Chekhovsky reaction, which is useful for the epoxide, or aziridines, or cyclopropane derivative preparations, or this sulfur halides can also be useful for the preparation of spirens, oxaspirens, alkenes, cyclopropanes, and then these sulfur halides can undergo rearrangement and gives you stable sulfides after rearrangement, and also some kind of aza sulfur halides undergo rearrangement and gives you heterocyclic compounds, and then oxa sulfur halides also undergo 3-2 sigmatropic rearrangement and gives you a benzofused heterocyclic compounds. And then there are important rearrangements or Pommerer rearrangement. This Pommerer rearrangement is mainly useful for the production of alpha azyl oxythioethers from the alkyl sulfoxides in presence of acetic anhydride. And the last application with this sulfur halide is Julia reaction, which is also called as Julia olefination, which is mainly useful for the synthesis of e-alkenes. So this is all about the synthetic applications of sulfur halides. Thank you.